What is good, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Mrs. and I'm here with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a first impression on the Makeup Revolution Fast Base Foundation Stick. I was so excited, like literally hella excited about this launch. I was one of those girls that I literally waited until midnight because it was launched on the 28th of February. I waited until midnight to process my order on Superdrug. Oh, I was so excited that I cancelled my nail appointment. So if you see my nails like this, like, just do not judge me because I can't stand when my nails are like this and when I'm filming. But I'm too excited, so let's just skip that. Without further ado, if you want to see what I've got and how these products perform on my skin tone, swatches and some specs, make sure you stay tuned and keep watching. Alright, so I've got my products in here because I obviously ordered on Superdrug. So I'm going to give you the specs about this foundation. Not really a lot of details, to be fair. So the product information states that the foundation just got faster, launching in 18 shades and a range of undertones. Fast base foundation quickly perfects, contours and highlights your complexion. The easy to apply stick formula melts into your skin, blend seamlessly to leave a fresh and dewy finish. It says twist up, swipe on and blend out with fingers, sponge or your favorite foundation brush, which is good because I do like a sponge or foundation brush. Then it lists all the foundation shades with the undertones specified in the description. So I got 4 because they only retail for £5, and to be honest, I think that's an absolute bargain. And even if I don't get my correct shade, and some of them obviously going to be darker, and these I can use it for occasions when I get a bit of tan or to contour. And to be honest, I feel like £5 is not really gonna break the bank. So these are the foundation stick here. So I got the shades 15, 16, 17, and 18. So hopefully I've got my correct foundation shade, but obviously I'll give you all the swatches of each foundation as well. This is one of the foundation sticks. So it comes in a really nice nude packaging with the rose ring around the barrel. As you can see, it is plastic, and then obviously you get your shade number underneath. And as you can see there, this is the rose gold barrel as well. So it looks really cool. And this is all the product that you get in one stick, which, to be fair, I think that's okay. I mean, there's obviously not a lot, but for £5, I don't really expect more. It's the first shade in the shade F15. Is it F15? Yeah, F15. And it looks like this. Oh, it feels really nice when you apply it, actually. It is a nice creamy consistency. So that is F15. Then you got F16, which looks like this. And I'll apply it here. So that obviously looks more red. Then you got F17, which looks like this. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. I'm not so sure if you can see it actually, but that's F17. Lastly, you got F18, which looks like this. Ooh. See that chocolate goodness? You see that goodness? So I thought to show you a little bit closer. So that is 15, then 16, 17, then 18. Sorry if the swatches are bad. So when it comes to matching my foundation, I always like to match my face to like my body chest area, because my hands, especially like my hands, is always the lightest part of my body. I do also have hyperpigmentation. So as you can see on this side of my face, I've got like darkness around my cheek area, around my mouth, and also under my eyes, and also my lids actually. And then this side I have color corrected, because I'm pretty sure that somewhere it was announced that it's a natural to medium buildable coverage, but it doesn't specify that on Tan Beauty or Superdrug. So I'm just gonna go for that anyway. So I'm gonna swatch 15. So that's 15, so 15 might be quite a good match. See, to me that looks lighter, but it's obviously just the undertone. This is 17. See, 17 looks like it can match me as well. And this is 18. So it says number 15 is a neutral undertone. Number 16 is a warm undertone. As you can see, it's like very warm. Number 17 is also a neutral undertone. And number 18 is a warm undertone. So I was pretty much right. So we are between, well, I'm deciding to use either 15 or 17. So I also have normal to dry skin. I am pretty much 100%, nah, I'm pretty much 98% normal. There's a little bit dry around my nose, which is mainly like my area that I'm dry the most. So I'm gonna narrow it down to 15 and 17, because to be honest, they're pretty much the same. I'm gonna use 15 first and see what it's like. But then I'm also going to use a sponge and a beauty blender as well. So I'm gonna apply it on the color corrected side. Okay, so that is that side done, yeah. So as you can see, I just swatched 17. So yeah, 17 will be a bit too dark. So even though the undertones is the same, the shade is dark and that looks like more gray and muddy, where 15 doesn't look like that. So yeah, I'm gonna stick to 15 actually. Yeah, I'm gonna wipe that off and stick to 15. Hey guys, so this is my face blended out. As you can see, it's looking nice and radiant and dewy. But yeah, I will have to say this shade is darker, and you know what, it's my mistake, because I remember when I bought the concealers, I got it in the shade 15 13 and 18, and I thought 15 was gonna be my shade, but I remember saying it was darker, so really and truly I should have went for 14. I'm not too sure why I didn't. Maybe when I looked at the swatches, for some reason I thought like it was just not gonna correspond with my undertones. But yeah, so what I'm gonna do, so far so good to be fair. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do the rest of my makeup off camera just to pretty much save time, and then I will get back to you guys shortly and show you like the final results. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay guys, so this is the completed look. So I went really nice, fresh and basic. I just wanted to do like a natural mini beat and just add some blush, a bit of highlight and some gloss, and pretty much good to go. So I think the foundation looks really, really well. It still has a bit of like a dewy glow, but not like heavily. But I would definitely say that after concealing, it neutralized and balanced out the skin tone, where before it looked a bit darker. So I did also order the C14 shade in the concealer, which looks like this. And let me swatch the F15 foundation, because I actually heard that the concealer is pretty much a correspondent color to the foundation. So the top swatch here is the concealer, which is C14, and the bottom one is the foundation in F15, sorry. So to be honest, if I got the foundation F14, it would pretty much match. Like, look at that, that pretty much matches my skin. Like, it pretty much blends in. Anyway, I will learn for next time. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna rock this foundation for the rest of the day. It doesn't claim any sort of longevity of how long the foundation is meant to hold up. So in that aspect, I don't really expect it to last like 24 hours or 12 hours. So I'm gonna test this out, see how I get on. But I really, really like the finish. And yeah, so if you don't wanna hear my final opinions, make sure you stay tuned, keep watching, and I'll see you guys in a bit. What's good peeps, thank you very much for staying tuned to watch the review part of this video. And yes, I did change my lipstick because I basically trying to take a picture of a thumbnail for another video. That's why I changed my lipstick. But without further ado, let's just get right into the review. Okay, so I forgot to mention that the first part of the video that I recorded was at 1:30 in the afternoon. It's now 9:09 in the evening. So this is what my face looks pretty much for a good few hours. So just get a, you know, good glimpse. Now, to start with the cons, as you could probably see around like my eyelids, because I've got very fine creases on my eyelids, there is obviously quite a lot of like moisture in between of the folds of the crease. So I did notice that around like after 2.5 hours. Also, around my smile lines, the foundation is pretty much settled in around my smile lines, and as you can see around my nose, it's a little bit shiny than usual, because I do tend to perspire a lot on my face, especially when I'm like hot and bothered, and the main area is around my nose, so you probably would see a bit of like shine and glistening there. But to be honest, that is pretty much it for the cons. Like, other than that, I think this foundation is absolutely beautiful. I think it's flawless on the skin. It blends that seamlessly with a sponge or a brush, so they are right with that. It's weightless, it's very light. Like, I absolutely love this foundation. The only thing I would advise is that if you're on a combination, if you're like a full full matte, if you're like a full coverage foundation, you're not going to get it out of this. This is more designed for a dewy finish. It's more designed for more of a, like a natural look. If you have problematic skin, acne scar or anything like that, you will need to conceal, color correct, spot correct, and add this foundation to hide that away. But if you have hyperpigmentation like myself, as you can see, it pretty much like concealed that, so it wasn't really too bad. So that's probably the only thing I would probably advise. And also the other little thing is the packaging. This is the type of packaging that will attract dirt, so you will see like your makeup mess on this, but it's easy to wipe away at the same time. So just a little FYI for that. But yeah, overall I absolutely love it. Makeup Revolution gets 2 thumbs up from me. Very impressed, absolutely happy with the shades. I know for a fact there are potential to put shades or two in between, like with different undertones, but 18 shades for the first launch, can't really complain with that. But yeah, that is pretty much from me. So if you did like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you are new, make sure you subscribe on your way out. To my oldies but goodies, thank you so much for supporting me, and I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye.